When a fixed amount is withdrawn by a partner at the end of every month at a fixed rate of interest, then the interest on drawing is calculated for 5.5 months. For example, Y withdrew rupees 1000 at the end of every month. Calculate his interest on drawing at the rate 10% per annum by both the methods, assuming the year ends on 31st December every year. So by simple interest method, he has withdrawn rupees 1000 and he is withdrawing it for 12 months. So total drawings comes to rupees 12,000. 12,000 into 10%, 10 by 100 into 5.5 months comes to 5 to the 10 plus 1 is equal to 11 by 2 into 12. So the total amount comes to 550. By product method, date, amount, withdrawn, period of utilization, product. On 31st of January 2019, he is withdrawing at the end of every month. 1000 has been withdrawn. Period utilized. This 1000 was utilized for 11 months because the entire month of January has passed away. So 11,000 is the product. Then in February 28th, 1000 was withdrawn. 10 months is the period of utilization, 10,000. 31/3/2013, 1000 has been withdrawn. 9 months is utilization period, 9000. On 30th April 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 8 months is utilization period, 8000. On 31st May 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 7 months is utilization period, 7000. Then on 30th June 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 6000 is the utilization period. 6 is the utilization period, 6000 is the product. On 31st July 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 5 months is utilization period, 5000. 31/8/2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 4 months is the utilization period, 4000. 30th September 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 3 months it is utilized, 3000 is the product. On 31st October 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 2 months is the utilization period, 2000 is the product. On 31st November 2019, 1000 has been withdrawn. 1 month is the period of utilization, 1000 is the product. On 31st December 2019, that is the last day of the month and the year, 1000 has been withdrawn. It will not be utilized. Nil is the product. We will add up the total product, comes to 66,000. So 1 month interest will be calculated at the rate of 10%. So 66,000 into 10 by 100 into 1 by 12, it comes to 5,500. This 5,500 is equal to this 5,500. Now case 3. When a fixed amount is withdrawn in the middle of every month at a fixed rate of interest, the interest on drawings is calculated for a period of 6 months. So at the middle of every month, if a fixed amount is withdrawn, interest is calculated for 6 months. Middle of every month means either on 14th of a month or 15th of a month. For example, Z withdrew rupees 1000 at the middle of every month up to 31st December 2019. Calculate his interest on drawings at the rate 10% per annum by both the methods. So by simple interest method, if he is withdrawing rupees 1000 per month for 12 months, he has withdrawn 12,000. 12,000 into 10%, 10 by 100, and for 6 months interest will be calculated, 6 by 12, it comes to rupees 600. By product method, date, amount, withdrawn, period of utilization, product. The first withdrawal he has made, say on 15th. of January 2019, 15 days of January has already passed. So this month was utilized for half of January and 11 rest of the month left in the year. So 11.5. So product comes to 11,500. He withdrew rupees 1,000 on 15th February. So the period of utilization here is 10.5. Total comes to 10,500. If he withdrew on 15th March 1,000 rupees, 9.5 is the period of utilization, 9,500. If he withdraws on April 15, 2019, 1,000, 8.5, 8,500. On 15th May 2019, 1,000 is withdrawn, 7.5, 7,500. On 15th June, 1,000 is withdrawn, 6.5 is period of utilization, 6,500. On 15th July 2019, 1,000 has been withdrawn, period of utilization, 5.5 is equal to 5,500. On 15th August 2019, 1,000 has been withdrawn, 4.5, 4,500. 15th September, 1,000 has been withdrawn, 3.5 is 3,500. On 15th October 2019, 1,000 has been withdrawn, 2.5 is the period of utilization, 2,500. On 15th November 2019, 1,000 has been withdrawn, 1.5 is the period of utilization, 1,500. On 15th December 2019, 1,000 has been withdrawn, only half month of December is the period of utilization, so 500. Total of the product comes to 72,000. 1 month interest at the rate 10% will be calculated, 72,000 into 10 by 100 into 1 by 12 is equal to 6,000. Now case 4th, when different amounts are withdrawn on different dates in a year, in that case the interest on drawings are calculated by applying the product method only. In this case simple method will not be used. That is, 1 month's interest at a given rate will be calculated. For example, A withdraws the following amounts on different dates. Calculate his interest on drawing at the rate 10% per annum. Dates are given 15 January 2019. He has withdrawn rupees 20,000. On 1st April 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 30,000. On 30th June 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 20,000. On 15th September 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 40,000. And on 1st December 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 30,000. So we will prepare the schedule. Date: on 15-1-2019, he has withdrawn 20,000. The period of utilization is 11.5 months. We will multiply them. 2,30,000 is the answer. Is the product. On 1st April 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 30,000. It is utilized for 9 months. 2,70,000 is the product. On 30th June 2019, he has withdrawn rupees 20,000. Period of utilization here is 6 months. Product comes to 1,20,000. On 15th September 2019, he has withdrawn 40,000. Period of utilization is 3.5 months. 1,40,000 is the product. On 1st December 2019, 30,000 has been withdrawn. 1 month is the period of utilization. 30,000 is the product. Total of the product comes to 7,90,000. 1 month interest at the rate 10% per annum will be the interest on drawing. 7,90,000 into 10 by 100 into 1 by 12. Total comes to 6,583.33, or we will round it off to 6,583 rupees.